Hi, I'm Arsham, and this series of videos about computer science and game development are sponsored by Kidacode. I've started taking a course called CS50 made by Harvard, which gives you all the knowledge you need for computer science and game development. And this series of videos are summarized versions of that course. Feel free to check it out for yourself. Now on to the video. In today's video, we're going to be talking about computer science. So let's start off by asking the question, what is computer science? Well, computer science can be simply defined as the process of solving problems. What does it mean to solve a problem? So we have an input, and the goal is to get some kind of output, which is the solution to a particular problem. And in between is computer science. And we'll see what's in this box as we begin to fill some of those blanks. But when we consider a problem to be solved, we have to find a way to represent the input and the output. But how? Which leads us to the first concept we explore in computer science, which is how you represent information itself. If you've had any prior knowledge of computers, you would know that the main way that computers communicate is through binary. Maybe you've heard the term binary, but not really sure how it works. Well, let's consider how most of us learned how to count, maybe with our hands first. If we want to count the people in the room, maybe I might do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, putting up a finger for every person in the room. So that's what's known as unary notation. We also have the decimal system, which has digits from 0 through 9. But computers don't have that many digits, they only have zeros and ones. And still somehow they're able to represent and show images, videos, letters, and much more. So how does this system work? Well, let's take a quick look at how you can build all the devices we use with just zeros and ones. For example, what does this represent? Yes, 224. But why? How can we tell what these series of lines and curves represent? Obviously, we all know it is 224, but why? We can use the ones, tens, and hundreds method to show that. We all know that the rightmost digit represents the number in the ones place, and the second is tens, and third is hundreds. So how do we get from this pattern of glyphs and symbols to the number 224? We can do some simple math by just multiplying the place the number is and the number itself, and doing this for the rest of them and eventually adding them up to get the number 224. This system of counting can let us find any number in the same way. So if we've got our ones place, tens place, and a hundreds place, of course, in the decimal world, this is the number 1. We also have the numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. But what happens after 9? It sort of gets carried to the tens. Now we have a 1 and a 0, which represents 10 in decimal. And this is a system we've been using for many years. But as you can notice, they're just powers of 10, like 10 power 0 is 1, 10 power 1 is 10, and so on and so forth. But it's a bit different for computers, since they don't have the numbers 0 through 9. They just have zeros and ones. But it's okay, we just have to make a small change in the same system we use for the decimals to make it work for computers as well. All we have to do is use powers of 2 instead of powers of 10, because we only have 2 digits to work with. So instead of having 1s, 10s, 100s, we can have 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, and so on and so forth. Okay, thank you for watching this video. This was the first part of the computer science course. In the next video, I'll be going over how binary works and other systems that we can use to represent data on computers. If you enjoyed this video, please feel free to subscribe and hit that notification bell, as it makes you notified every time I upload. Thank you for watching this video, and bye bye.